Hey guys and dolls, welcome to Uncommon Sense, the new long-form version of Brianna X. Robinson, where we talk about culture, politics, wellness, and whatever else we want to. I'm your host, Brianna Robinson, and let's get into it. So I came across this article by Vogue on the rise of baby girl men and what that means for fashion. Let me read you some of this. Baby girl is a designation that's given out when we find this person not just hot, but interesting, worthwhile. It's a word that gets ascribed to a guy who is adorable and of whom there is a general sentiment of acceptance and culture. It's someone that we've more or less universally decided to love, and they give examples like Harry Styles. Baby girl men are also typically comfortable enough with their masculinity to bend the rules around gender when dressing. Pedro Pascal, Timothée Chalamet, and whoever that other person is, have rocked up to recent award shows in women's runway looks. In Vogue Runway's year-end poll, gender-bending menswear was dubbed the industry's favorite 2023 trend. Imagine that. In the last year or so, Jacob Elordi, was rarely seen without a designer handbag. All of these Hollywood heartthrobs in these little tops carrying these little bags. Ugh. Okay, so here's the important part, because who cares about what Hollywood's doing, right? Social media is a key driver. TikTok, fan cams, and edits have really shifted our perceptions, influences, and ideas regarding men's fashion and how it's not just about suits anymore. Stans are so good at their job in shifting the mainstream group mentality that you have regular hetero cis men open to the idea of carrying a handbag. That's really powerful. It's constantly on our feeds, being reposted, and positively encouraged. Now she says women are being influenced by menswear like never before, and vice versa. Retailers are taking note and buying accordingly. The Rose Margot bag is a bestseller within menswear, yet officially belongs to the women's collections. It would be easy to just roll our eyes at Hollywood and say, who cares? These people are of no consequence to me, they don't impact my life. But they do, because trends are manufactured and pushed out to the public, and it starts first by the people with the greatest influence. And I can tell you anecdotally that I know a lot of guys who didn't used to wear nail polish, but now do because it's cool and it's trendy. I know guys who wear pearls and women's jewelry now. So yeah, Hollywood might be ridiculous, and you and I might not care what Hollywood's doing, but we should care as far as it touches culture and the people around us. Also, does anyone else find it creepy that the words baby girl and men are being used to describe the same thing? When these male Hollywood celebrities show up to red carpets in their little sheer tops and their women's runway looks with their handbags and their pearls and their painted nails, it reminds me of back in the day when aristocrats used to wear white wigs and stockings and the little heels. Only the most privileged in society can be ridiculous like this. The real men who carry society on their backs are not wearing frills and bows and sheer tops, and they're not carrying little purses. If your goal is to destroy a strong society, feminizing men and masculinizing women, all of this gender bending, and then destroying the family unit, it's the best way to do that. So congratulations to these baby girl men for collapsing society. Your inclusive dressing is not a win, it's not attractive, and other nations are literally laughing at us. So my dad used to take me to do a lot of off-roading when I was a kid. That was like one of our favorite things to do as a family. Now back in the 80s and 90s, there was a legendary event called the Camel Trophy, referred to as the Olympics of 4x4. It was an annual off-roading competition where teams of men would compete to get their Land Rovers across all kinds of terrain, usually in a jungle-type environment. The vehicles were heavily tricked out beforehand, and the teams used any means necessary to get it across the course. In gender bending and trying to steer the culture towards the feminization of men, you are stripping men of their nature. You are making them unattractive to women. The puppet masters are trying to brainwash us into believing that a man carrying a handbag and wearing dainty attire is heartthrob material. They're casting these baby girl men in these heartthrob roles and then telling us through publications like Vogue and through social media that this is attractive, that this is what women want. It's not. And you know what? The Indiana Jones types are always going to win the day, because that natural polarity is what's attractive. Let's take a moment to remember when Hollywood gave us real heartthrobs and respected masculinity. Okay, so we're gonna discuss something that I unfortunately found on the internet, and I had to see it, so now you have to see it. And that is self-love weddings. Yes, it's as cringy as it sounds. People are throwing full weddings with gifts, ceremonies, a wedding party, the whole enchilada, to marry themselves. Let's take a look at this.
A few weeks ago, I went to a self-love wedding. So my friend, Marcy, I love you, married themselves for their birthday. Everyone had to dress up as the opposite sex, or if you're non-binary, you got to choose. So here are some of those outfits. And here's mine. The ceremony was so beautiful. There was even a flower girl, and Marcy looked so beautiful. The whole ceremony made me want to cry. I did shed a few tears. But I was so happy to experience this and the love in the room.
Those are exactly the type of people that I would expect to see at a self-love wedding. They killed it. The eyebrows, the half-naked belly dancer, the gender-bending attire. It was perfect. It was perfect. Okay, let's watch the next one. This one is by Amma Pound Cake. Okay, let's watch it. Don't make me have to remind ya. I got my cup up to the heavens. Another night I won't remember. I promise this my move forever. Promise this my move forever, ever. Dress is dancing on the bezel. It's kind of feeling unforgettable. Promise this my move forever. Promise this my move forever. Oh my gosh. She had people giving speeches. She had gifts. She had an entire wedding party, and she made them take pictures of her with her while she sat on a throne. The sheer narcissism of this all. If I was invited to a self-love wedding, there is a 0% chance that I would go. Okay, so last one. This guy is going to explain to us a little bit more detail about what it means to marry yourself and what that looks like. So let's go.
I married myself years ago, and I want to teach you how to do this as well. First off, I want to just say that I think it's wildly inappropriate that we teach children that you should grow up and marry someone else one day, but never think to teach children that they should probably marry themselves first. But that's just my personal opinion. Now, I wear a ring, but you could do anything. You could wear a necklace, you could get a tattoo, just something to symbolize your marriage to yourself. P.S. I did this right after a breakup, and it was something really important I needed to do for myself. And something you probably need to do for yourself right now, too. And I encourage you to write vows to yourself. Think about the things that you want someone else to promise to you. Promise them to yourself. But I used the quite traditional vows. I told myself that I was going to love myself through richer and poorer, through sickness and health, through all shapes and sizes of this body, till death do I leave this body. And I renew these vows every so often because we need to. I'd love to hear some of the things that you want to say to yourself in your own vows, and let's normalize.
Yes, let's normalize this. This is clearly healthy. All of these people look and sound very healthy. We should definitely normalize this. Pretty sure that making promises to yourself is what people do when they make New Year's resolutions. I don't think you need to marry yourself to make a promise. And you know, I'm not a scholar, but I'm pretty sure the definition of marriage involves the joining together of two things. Let's look up the formal definition, okay? Define marriage. The legally or formally recognized union of two people as partners in a personal relationship, historically and in some jurisdictions, specifically a union between a man and a woman. The second definition is a combination or mixture of two or more elements. So no, you cannot marry yourself. That's not a thing. You can make promises to yourself. You can throw yourself a party. I'm pretty sure that's what birthdays are for. But you can't marry yourself. I'm all for self-love. You should love yourself. You should have a healthy amount of care, compassion, and respect for yourself. If you don't have a healthy relationship with yourself, the way you interact with the world changes. People who have a healthy relationship with themselves and a healthy view of themselves generally are more confident. They make better friends, better business partners, more trustworthy. They tend to accomplish more in life. They're physically healthier and less prone to disease. However, these self-love weddings reflect a deep narcissism that has taken root in our culture. It is an overcompensation for simply being insecure. Nobody knows who they are anymore, because you can be a man, a woman, an it, or a purple squirrel these days. We have so many adults who came from broken homes. The divorce rates are just off the charts, and everyone is godless. Everyone's just questioning who they are and where they fit into this world and why it even matters. And that's how you end up with self-love weddings and people who shave off their eyebrows. That's how you end up with they-thems. Anyways, I think it's important to laugh at this stuff because, I don't know, we could be really sad and depressed about it, and we should pray for these people. They need it. But the world is dark enough already, and if you don't have a sense of humor about it, you're gonna have a very hard go at life. So I hope you found some humor in this like I did. That's all I have for you guys today. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to see more content just like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.